I was sort of interested in science, more because one of my uncles had a chemistry set, but I never was a big wild enthusiast about it. And by the time I was 14 is when I think my uncles were Marxists, three of them. The other two were capitalists, so it was that constant family tension. That's my mother's family. I never lived with my biological father. And so I think that during when I was growing up, I don't remember how I got into it, but I always had a romantic idea what the West was like, and I always had my mind set on going out west to go to school. By the time it was time to graduate, I had applied. I wanted to go to the University of Arizona, and for some reason, I didn't get in, but I did get into the University of Colorado. And I graduated from high school when I was not yet 17. Before that, I was good in math. So if you were good in math, you could, I got 100 on the Regents exam. And, that got me into Stuyvesant High School, okay? So New York, Stuyvesant High School was the, and still is, the leading high school for science. Although I haven't been in contact with them at all lately. I don't know how many other majors the people study at science, but, other than science. But when I got there, I don't know why when I look back, I regret that somehow there was nobody that mentored me there. They didn't take a kid and assign him to somebody. Everybody was on their own, and if you were good enough to do it on your own, fine. But I never got into science, and I don't know why I didn't particularly like biology, and I was attracted to languages. So in high school, I studied Spanish and German. I couldn't take more than one language. And so at the end of the first year or two at Stuyvesant, I packed it in, because on top of which, I had to travel all the way from the Bronx on the subway down to 14th Street in New York, which, when I was telling you about the lecture coming up, that's where it's going to be, at 14th Street, which was an experience in itself, going down there every day. Because in New York, kids travel when they're 9 or 10 years old without the slightest hesitation, go from one end of the city to the other for a nickel. And so I left Stuyvesant and I went to a high school in the Bronx, the DeWitt Clinton High School, which is a huge school. It's more like a college. It always reminded me, at that time, the school, for some reason, was on three shifts. There was when you were a freshman, you would go for the morning shift, and if you were a senior or a junior, you could go the afternoon shift. So I didn't have to get to school until 12 o'clock every day, and I could sleep late. And on top of which, they weren't all that demanding as they were. I don't think, in Stuyvesant, I think they were just more of a challenge. But so I studied German and Spanish. I belonged to the Spanish club. And I remember one of my Spanish teachers was a guy who was the editor of the Latino newspaper in New York. Latino is the language spoken by the Sephardic Jews who were kicked out of Spain, okay? And it's Spanish with Hebrew characters, okay? Which But by the way, I attended what do they call it, the Hebrew school or Cheder for about a week. I hated it, and I just wanted to go out, and I wanted to play baseball. And my mother was very very easygoing person. Never made me do anything I didn't want to do. So I said, I don't want to go to this thing, and I didn't. So I never was bar mitzvah.